فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. We still in the sharah and the explanation of the book مختصر في أصول العقائد الدينية written by العلامة عبد الرحمن ابن ناصر السعدي رحمه الله. We finished the first two أصل, the first two foundations and fundamentals. We're now going to go on to the third from the five fundamentals, the third inshallah ta'ala. نعم.
الأصل الثالث الإيمان باليوم الآخر.
The author رحمه الله, he goes into the third أصل, the third foundation, and he named it الإيمان, to believe in اليوم الآخر, the day of judgment, is to believe in the day of judgment. And what is the day of judgment? The day of judgment is ما يكون بعد الموت, that which is going to be after death. So if somebody asks you, what does it mean, اليوم الآخر? It means ما يكون بعد الموت, that which will take place after death. And this is a question that one may want to ask, why is it that Sheikh Abdul Rahman Nasir al-Sa'idi over here and Abu al-Abbas Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah in his Aqidah al-Wasatiyah, and of course the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam as well, why did he mention al-Imanu bil-Yawm al-Akhiri, the belief of the day of judgment, but they didn't mention the belief of death? The reason is because, the reason why they didn't mention al-Imanu bil-Mawti, the belief of the death, is because لأن الموت لا يمكن أحد جحده. Because death, there's no one who can actually be stubborn enough to disagree the existence of death and argue against it. فإن الناس جميعا, all type of people, على اختلاف ملالهم, different types of religion there is, وَنِحَلِهِمْ وَأُمَمِهِمْ, the different nations and different groups and different ideologies that people possess, all and each and every one of them, مُقِرُّونَ, they all believe بِأَنَّ الْمَوْتَ وَاقِعٌ بِهِمْ, that death is going to come to them. But what is the issue that arises? The شأن, the reality and the issue between all of them is بِمَا يَكُونُ بَعْدَهُ, that which is going to take place after it. And pay attention now. What happens, ما يكون بعد الموت, that which happens after death is of two types, صحيح? The things that take place after death are two types. I mean, there are two things that take place after death. Hayat, which is known as Hayat al-Barzakhiyah, and the last one, which is known as Al-Hayat al-Akhirah, Al-Hayat al-Qiyamah. Al-Hayat al-Barzakhiyah is three things. Fitnatul Aqabr. The second one is عذاب القبر ونعيمه. And the third one is النفخ في الصور. It is the fitna, the trials and tribulations of the grave. The second one is عذاب, the punishment of the grave, and the blessings and the bliss in the grave. And the third one is النفخ في الصور, the blowing inside the trumpet. Then we have الحياة الآخرة, the belief of the hereafter, which is after the barzakh. The barzakh. And that is 10 things. البعث, الحشر, الشفاعة, نشر الصحف, الحساب, وزن الأعمال, الحوض, الصراط, القنطرة, الجنة والنار. They are 10 things. البعث, the resurrection, الحشر, the gathering, الشفاعة, the intercession, النشر الصحف, the scrolls being opened up. الحساب, the accountability, وزن الأعمال, the scaling of the actions, الحوض, the fountain, الصراط, the path that the people are going to tread on, Al-Qantara, a place where the people are going to stay after they go past the Sirat. A stage is where, which is called the Qantara, where the people will be imprisoned before they go to Jannah and Nar. And then last but not least, Al-Jannatu wa Nar. The Jannah and the Nar. Those are the 10 things which are Hayatul Akhirah. As for Hayatul Barzakh is Adab, Fitnatul Qabr, Adabul Qabri wa Na'imuh, and last but not least, Al-Nafqu fi Sur. There are two things that can actually nullify a person's belief of the Day of Judgment. And that is Inkaruhu, if you actually believe, say that it doesn't even exist. Once we die, we're dead. There's nothing after it. And the second one is Ta'wilu Yawm Al-Akhirati. If you start distorting the meaning of the Day of Judgment and you start giving it different meanings and interpretations. Now, so the author, rahimahullah, this is what he's talking about when he speaks about Al-Imanu Bil Yawm Al-Akhiri, believing in the Day of Judgment. Now,
فكل ما جاء به الكتاب والسنة مما يكون بعد الموت فإنه من الإيمان باليوم الآخر.
So the Sheikh رحمه الله says every single thing in which the Kitab and the Sunnah mention مما يكون بعد الموت, that which will take place after death. So it's all after death. And that's what is the meaning of يوم الآخرة, is anything after death, whether it's حياة البرزخية or حياة الآخرة, right? نعم. فإنه من الإيمان باليوم الآخر. It falls under believing in the Day of Judgment. Anything that takes place after death is called what? الإيمان باليوم الآخر. لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول من مات قامت قيامته. Anyone who dies, his qiyamah has been, it took place. If you die, your qiyamah has started. And then the Shaykh gives examples. هيا ك
كأحوال البرزخ.
And that's, see? أحوال البرزخ is حياة البرزخية. And as I said, there are three things: فتنة القبر, عذاب القبر ونعيمه, النفخ في الصور. نعم.
وأحوال يوم القيامة.
And I said 10 things: البعث, in order, these are in order: البعث والحشر والشفاعة ونشر الصحف والحساب ووزن الأعمال الحوض الصراط القنبرة القنطرة and the جنة والنار. نعم.
وما فيها من الحساب والثواب والثواب والعقاب والشفاعة والميزان والصحف المأخوذة
المأخوذة
المأخوذة باليمين والشمال والصراط وأحوال الجنة والنار وأحوال أهلهما وأنواع ما أعد الله فيهما لأهلهما إجمالا وتفصيلا فكل ذلك داخل في الإيمان باليوم الآخر.
All of those, they fall under it. What is it? الحساب, accountability. الثواب والعقاب, how the people going to be accounted the Day of Judgment? They're going to be accounted either by ثواب, reward, or عقاب, punishments. شفاعة, intercession, we believe in it. الميزان, the scale. الصحف, scrolls that your actions are written on. The actions that you came with. المأخوذة, that will be taken by باليميني. Some people are going to take it with their rights and some people are going to take it with their lefts. Left was sirat, the sirat that people are going to take. وأحوال الجنة والنار, and the situation of the people of Jannah and Nar. وأحوال أهلهما, and the people who are going to reside in both of them. وأنواع ما أعد الله, and also the different types of things in which Allah has prepared for the people of Jannah and the people of Nar. إجمالا وتفصيلا, in general and in details. فكل ذلك داخل, each and everything of that, it falls under al-iman bil-yawm al-akhir, believing in the Day of Judgment. So if you don't believe the sirat, then you don't believe in the Day of Judgment. If you say, I believe in the Day of Judgment, but I don't believe in the hisab, or I don't believe, for example, the qantara, or I don't believe in Jannah and Nar, or I don't believe in al-ba'th, or I don't believe in hashar, all of those are parts of the day, believing in the Day of Judgment, which you have to believe. And if you miss one of them out, then you don't believe in the Day of Judgment. You don't believe in the Day of Judgment. Shaykh al-Islam ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he mentions something very powerful, and he says that the situation of the people on the Sirat, the Day of Judgment, is based on how they are on the path of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this world. The people's foot, it being steadfast and strong on the Sirat, the Day of Judgment, is based upon how they are this dunya, the way they are towards the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the sunnah and the Prophet's way alayhi salatu wasalam. Na'am.
Al-aslu rabi' mas'alatu al-iman.
So the Shaykh rahimahullah, he now goes into what is known as musamma al-iman. The aslu rabi', the fourth asal, which is the issue of what's known as musamma al-iman, mas'alatu al-iman, or the issue of iman. Now, the issue of iman, I'm going to summarize it, and then inshallah ta'ala we're going to go bit by bit in the statement of the Shaykh rahimahullahu ta'ala. The issue of iman, what you need to understand is there are three things that it stands on if you want to be in accordance to Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah in the issue of al-iman. The first point is that al-imanu qawlun wa amal. That the iman is qawl, which is speech, amal, which is actions. That's the first point. And when we say qawl, two things come out of it. Qawlul qalbi and qawlul lisan. The qawl, the speech of the heart, and the speech of the tongue. Both of them are considered, they're both what? Qawl. Qawlul qalbi, the speech of the heart, and qawlul lisan. And qawlul al-lisan. Then we have amal. The amal. Amal is of two types as well. Amalul qalb and amalul jawarih. The actions of the heart and the actions of the limbs. Okay? So those are the two. Each one, two comes out of it. So basically we have four. Where does this four come from? They brought it from the Kitab and the Sunnah. But there's one hadith that all of them, هذه الأمور الأربعة يجمعها. There's one hadith that brings all four of those. Four of what? قول القلب قول القلب وقول اللسان العمل القلب and عمل الجوارح. Those four. There's one narration that brings them all together. And that's the hadith of the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, which is الإيمان بضع وستون الشعبة. And that's the correct opinion. This hadith is, inshallah ta'ala, there are many wordings that come. And Imam Muslim brought it in two wordings in his Sahih. بضع وسبعون بضع وستون. And Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah brought it in, is sahih. In what? Bid'un wa situna. And that's the correct wording. That is bid'un wa situna. 63. So pay attention to this hadith. This hadith is going to give us all four of them. And that is what? Al-imanu bid'un wa situna shu'ba. A'laha qawlu la ilaha illallah. The highest of them is qawlu la ilaha illallah. Qawlu la ilaha illallah is what? Qawlu al-qalb and qawlu al-lisan. So the qawlul qalb means at-tasdiqul jazim. It's not mujarradu at-tasdiq. Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah refutes that in Kitab al-Iman. Some place, even in his Kitab al-Iman, he actually says it's not even tasdiq aslan. He says call it iqrar. But that itself can be questioned. Ala kulli hal, at-tasdiqul jazim, Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he said it is. It's not mujarradu at-tasdiq. It's not just a mere tasdiq. It's a tasdiq that's jazim, that is with unwavering conviction. So that's qawlul qalb. So when a person says La ilaha illallah, that has to be in his heart. Then what is it? Qawlul lisan, which is the nut of the shahadatain, the pronunciation of the word, at the utterance of it, saying Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. The person has to say it. Unless of course he is mute, he can't speak or whatnot. Those are then exceptions. But generally the person has to say the la shahadatain. Sahih? Are you with me? Which is qawlul lisan. The hadith says A'laha qawlu la ilaha illallah. So we have that. What do we have here? We have qawlul qalb and qawlul lisan. Then we need what? The two remaining of amal. Amalul qalb and we need amalul jawarih. Which is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's speech. Imatatul adha anil tariq. Removing harm from the path. That's amalul jawarih. The actions of the limb. Wal haya, shyness is a shu'ba min shu'ab al iman. And shyness is a branch from the branches of al-iman. And this is what? Amalul qalb. It's the actions of the heart. It's the action of the heart. Then these four that I mentioned, which is qawlul qalb, qawlul lisan, amalul qalb, and amalul jawarih, all four of them is found all in this hadith of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, the hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari al-Muslim. So that's the first thing we need to know, which is al-imanu qawlun wa amal. That the iman is what? Qawlun and amal. That's Ahlul Sunnah. The opinion they hold, ijma'at and consensus have been brought. Abu Qasim Hibatullah al-Lakai in his Kitab Sharh Usul I'tiqadi al-Sunnah wal Jama'ah, he brings the consensus of Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah, and of course it's present in the Kitab and the Sunnah. The second thing that the person needs to understand the issue of al-iman is yazidu bil ta'a wa yanqusu bil ma'asiyah. That the iman increases with what? that the iman increases and it decreases. It increases with obedience and it decreases with disobedience. Pay attention to this. So the first point that you have to know about the issue of iman is what? And the iman is qawlun wa amal. That the iman is qawl and amal, actions and speech. The second part which you need to know about the iman is what? Pay attention. Is that the iman yazidu bitta'a, increases with obedience and it decreases with what? Disobedience. So yazidu bitta'a wa yanqusu bil ma'siyah. And there are evidence, many evidence in the Quran that show that the iman increases. الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسُ Allah says, الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسُ سُوءٍ إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَخْشَوْهُمْ فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا. The iman increases. The iman increased. Allah says also, الَّذِينَ يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا وَعَلَى جُنُوبِهِمْ وَيَتَفَكَّرُونَ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. لا. الَّذِينَ يَذْكُرُونَ Allah says, الَّذِينَ إِذَا Allah, the قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى was a statement of Allah تبارك وتعالى. الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم وإذا تليت عليهم آيات زادتهم إيمانا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. When the recitation of the verse of Allah تبارك وتعالى is done, the iman increases. Also Allah says ويزداد الذين آمنوا إيمانا ويزداد الذين آمنوا إيمانا. Then there are many verses in the Quran which prove that iman increases, and there are many evidences also that show that iman decreases. From the evidences that show that iman decreases is the Prophet's statement where he said to the women, مَا رَأَيْتُ I have never seen مِن نَاقِصَاتِ عَقْلٍ وَدِينٍ. I have never seen, the Prophet is saying this, anyone more deficient in intelligence and religion than you, meaning the women. نعم, أَذْهَبَ لِذِي لُبِّن مِنْ إِحْدَاكُنَّ. I have not seen, the Prophet said, anyone who's more deficient in intelligence and also in religion than you. But then look what the Prophet said after that. A cautious, sensible man. A man who's sensible and he's cautious. Who's protecting himself. He's making sure that he's sensible and everything. Could be led astray by one of those women. She can actually persuade him and convince him into something. Na'am. But this hadith, what did it show us? مَا رَأَيْتُ مِن نَاقِصَاتِ عَقْلٍ وَدِينٍ. The deen here is actually the iman decreases. And the Prophet explained when it is. Is that when one of them is on her menstruation, when she's on her menstruation, her iman decreases. And this is what happens to many of the sisters. Whilst they're on their menstruation, the iman actually decreases. So the iman decreases. Also, there's a hadith of the Prophet ﷺ where he said, عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ مَنْ رَأَى مِنْكُمْ مُنْكَرًا فَلْيُغَيِّرْهُ بِيَدِهِ فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطِعْ فَبِلِسَانِهِ فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطِعْ فَبِقَلْبِهِ وَذَلِكَ أَضْعَفُ الْإِيمَانِ وَذَلِكَ أَضْعَفُ الْإِيمَانِ. And that's the lowest of iman. That's the weakest of iman. And then the iman is strong and it becomes strong and it can become qawi and it can also become weak. So that's the second thing that we believe of the issue of iman. So the first one was what? Al-imanu qawlun wa amal. The second one is yazidu bitta'ati wa yanqusu bil ma'asiyah. The third thing which we need to believe is jawazu al-istithna, the permissibility of exception. Fil imani لا باعتبار أصله. This is important. جواز الاستثناء. That you believe there can, a person says, أنا مؤمن إن شاء الله. That's an استثناء. I am a believer إن شاء الله, if Allah wills. But pay attention to this, yeah. That doesn't mean when you say أنا مؤمن, I am a believer إن شاء الله. When you say that, it does not mean the أصل of the iman that you're talking about. So let me break this down. The permissibility of using the istithna according to A'immah to Sunnah, the ulama of the Sunnah, they actually meant three reasons. Are you there? They meant three reasons why you can say, you say, ana mu'minun insha'Allah. And if you say other than that, then you're wrong. Are you with me? Pay attention to this. The first one is that when you say ana mu'minun insha'Allah is referring to kamalul iman. It's referring to the kamal of the iman. It means that you're not able to come with every jami'u ta'at, every act of obedience or every speech of obedience, you're not able to come with it. And you're not also what? You're not also able to leave off jami'u al-manahi. You're not also able to leave off the jami'u al-nawahi, the things that you're prohibited from. You're also not able to leave off the what? Jami'u al-nawahi, all the things that you're prohibited from. You're not able to do that. So when you say أنا مؤمن inshallah, the reason why you say that is because there are some ta'at which you haven't come with. And there are also some things you are prohibited from, told to stay away from, you falling into. So you're referring to the kamaluhu al-wajib of the iman. But you're not referring to what? You're not referring to aslul iman. The second one is that al-qabulu inda Allah. Even the act that you do, you don't know if it's accepted by Allah. And Allah says in the Quran, innama yataqabbalu Allahu min al-muttaqeen. That Allah accepts from those who are pious. So when you're saying ana mu'minun insha'Allah, you're referring to the acceptance of this action of iman from you. Does that make sense? Huh? This act of iman that you're coming with, you're talking about it from the angle of acceptance. Na'am. Number three, which is khawfan min tazkiyatin nafs. You're actually scared of what? You're actually scared of your tazkiyatun nafs, praising yourself. You're actually scared of praising yourself. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said in the Quran, فَلَا تُزَكُّ أَنفُسَكُمْ هُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِمَنِ اتَّقَى. Do not praise yourself. فَلَا تُزَكُّ أَنفُسَكُمْ. Don't praise yourself. هُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِمَنِ اتَّقَى. Allah knows the one who is pious from amongst you. And then these three points are what Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah speak about when they're talking about the issue of Al-Iman. The first point they're talking about is Al-Imanu qawlun wa amal. The second one is يَزِيدُ بِالطَّاعَةِ وَيَنْقُصُ بِالْمَعْصِيَةِ. And the third thing they're talking about is Jawazul istithna'i fil imani la bi'atibari aslihi. Once we've understood that, inshaAllah ta'ala, we can then go into what the Shaykh is saying, rahimahullah ta'ala. So we're going to put all of his speech, inshaAllah ta'ala, in the right heading of all of that, inshaAllah ta'ala. Naam.
فَأَهْلُ السُّنَّةِ يَعْتَقِدُونَ مَا جَاءَ بِهِ الْكِتَابُ وَالسُّنَّةِ.
أهل السنة والجماعة, they believe everything that has come in the Kitab and the Sunnah. We believe every single thing that the Quran and the Sunnah has come. We believe it. Naam.
مِنْ أَنَّ الْإِيمَانَ هُوَ تَصْدِيقُ الْقَلْبِ.
That the iman is what? تَصْدِيقُ الْقَلْبِ. The belief of the heart. Naam.
الْمُتَضَمِّنُ لِأَعْمَالِ الْجَوَارِحِ.
That which consists of it. So if you have تَصْدِيقُ الْقَلْبِ, this tasdeeq which is in your heart, and as I said to you before, laysa huwa at-tasdeeq al-mujarrad. It is not just a mere belief. It is a belief which is at-tasdeeq al-jazim. It is a tasdeeq which is with certainty. It's a tasdeeq which is with certainty. So we don't want somebody having tasdeeq arid. It has to be tasdeeq which is jazim. It has to be majzuman. ولذلك شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية أبو العباس ابن تيمية in his كتاب الإيمان, he spoke about this in more details, and he refuted the issue, the concept of the murji'a, who went short on this issue, رحمه الله. نعم.
فيقولون الإيمان اعتقادات القلوب وأعمالها.
So Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, what do they believe? And what do they say? فَيَقُولُونَ. Who are the ones who is referring to here? He's referring to Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. They say al-Imanu i'tiqadat, that the Iman is belief of the heart. وَأَعْمَالُهَا, and its actions. So it's not just a mere belief. It also shows on the limbs. نعم. And on the person's actions. نعم.
وَأَعْمَالُ الْجَوَارِحِ وَأَكْوَالُ اللِّسَانِ وأنها كلها من الإيمان.
So أعمال الجوارح, أقوال اللسان, أعمال اعتقادات القلوب. All of them are what? We already spoke about it. We how many types did we categorize into? Four. قول القلب, قول اللسان, عمل القلب, and عمل الجوارح. Basically, all four of those are under iman. They are what? شعبة من شعب الإيمان. They are branch from the branches of الإيمان. نعم.
وأن من أكملها ظاهرا وباطنا فقد أكمل الإيمان.
So pay attention. Are you with me, brothers? Anyone who completes them, completes what? The ones that are internal and the ones that are external, then what will happen to him? فقد أكمل الإيمان. He completes his iman. So basically, pay attention. If you complete your قول القلب, are you there? قول القلب and قول اللسان, عمل القلب and عمل الجوارح, each and every one of them, then your iman is complete. ظاهراً وباطناً, internally and externally. نعم.
فقد أكمل الإيمان ومن انتقص شيئاً منها فقد انتقص من إيمانه, وهذه الأمور بدع وسبعون شعبة.
So the Sheikh says, رحمه الله, and if they, ومن انتقص شيئاً منها, if any one of those, قول القلب and قول اللسان عمل القلب عمل الجوارح whichever of those decreases فقد انتقص من إيماني then it passes إيمان decreases with it وهذه الأمور بضع وسبعون شعبة are you there and all of them are what they are بضع وسبعون شعبة they are of branches نعم but remember some of them are أصل if you leave it you leave the religion and some of them if you leave it you're not necessarily a what you're not a kafir نعم
أعلاها قول لا إله إلا الله وأدناها إماطة الأذى عن الطريق والحياء شعبة من الإيمان.
This is the hadith that we mentioned, which is in صحيحين. It's in صحيح البخاري and المسلم من حديث أبي هريرة from the noble companion Abu Huraira. And that shows us that the imans of three types, right? شعبة قلبية شعبة لسانية and شعبة عملية, right? نعم.
ويرتبون على هذا الأصل الأصلي أن الناس في الإيمان درجات مقربون وأصحاب يمين وظالمون لأنفسهم بحسب مقاماتهم من الدين والإيمان.
الشيخ رحمه الله he mentioned something here which is that The people in Iman, they are of darajat, they are of levels, and they are of different statuses. They're not all ala wathiratin wahida. They're not of all one level. People are different, and they differ from one person to another. The first one is the muqarrabun, and then ashabul yameen, and then the dhalimu li anfusihim. And the Shaykh expands on it more, so we're going to see it very soon, inshallah ta'ala, what he means by each one. Na'am.
وأنه يزيد وينقص فمن فعل محرما أو ترك واجبا نقص إيمانه الواجب ما لم يتب إلى الله.
So here the Sheikh is telling you that the iman increases, but what's the thing that increases the iman? طاعة, obedience, and also the iman decreases. Are you there? And what is it that decreases it? Disobedience. Then pay attention. Are you there? The iman decreases in the obedience of shaitan. It decreases when the person obeys shaitan. And it increases when the person obeys Ar-Rahman, Allah Tabaraka Ta'ala. So it's important that a person knows that what's causing your iman to decrease is either you're leaving a command that you were told to come with or you're falling into a prohibition which you were told to stay away from. So that is what brings a person Iman to decrease. And the opposite is what makes it increase. If you follow a command you were told to follow, and you stay away from a prohibition you were told to stay away from, then your Iman increases. And the person's Iman, it increases on that. ولذلك, the Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah, here is where the mawdi'un niza'. This is where Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah are arguing with the deviated groups. The deviated groups, to them, the Iman is one thing. It's a juz'un la yatajazza. It's one compound. It doesn't move. For them, every part of it is an asal. Whether it be the murji'a or whether it be the khawarij. Pay attention. That's why the murji'a didn't want to bring the action into the iman asalatan. Because they believe that this is what the iman is. And all of this is asal. Does that make sense? All of this is a what? It's a fundamental foundation. As for the Khawarij, they did the same. They brought their actions in and they made every part of the action an asal. Does that make sense? Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, what did they say? And this, I'm saying this is a statement said by Muhammad Nasr al-Marwazi in his kitab Ta'zim al-Qadr al-Salah. Also, Al-Imam Ibn Mandah says this in his kitab. Huh? In his kitab, Kitab al-Iman, Ibn Mandah. Muhammad Nasr al-Marwazi says it in his kitab Ta'zim al-Qadr al-Salah. Even Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali says it in his sharh of Kitab Sahih al-Bukhari, Fathul Bari. Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali. Ibn Rajab. He has a book called Kitabu. He has Fathul Bari, which is a sharh of Sahih al-Bukhari. Scholars, they differ on whether Ibn Hajar got it from him or not. But what seems to be right is that he did get it from him, the name. And that Ibn Hajar did actually see the sharh and explanation of Ibn Rajab. Ala kulli hal, Ibn Rajab also explains this, that what? Ahlul Sunnah, this is what they say. Al-Imanu qawlun wa amal that the iman is qawl and amal illa anna lahu aslan wa fara, that it has an asl and that it has a fara, sub branch. Pay attention to this, it's very important. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah clearly mentioned in this particular point, which is what? That the iman has an asl and it has a fara. Once a person says this, that the iman has an asl and the iman has a fara, the minute he says that, فَقَدْ خَرَجَ مِنَ الْإِرْجَاءِ وَالْخَوَارِجِ بِرُمَّتِهَا, that person has left Khawarijism and he's also left what? And he's also left Irja. Because it's in the Murji'a and the Khawarij don't believe that the iman has an asl and a fara. They don't believe that. Are you there? And the Sunnati wal Jama'ah, the ones who believe that. So, are you with me? That's why they believe the iman increases and decreases. That's why they believe that the iman increases and decreases. Because for them it's what? If it was all an asal, would it decrease or will it nullify? It will nullify. It will nullify. Sahih? Whereas the Khawarij, they believe it's either there or it's not there. The Murji'ah believe it's there or it's not there. And the Sunnah wal Jama'ah believe it can be there, but it can be weak and deficient. Naam? Sahih? Naam.
ويرتبون على هذا الأصل أن الناس ثلاثة أقسام.
So the people are three types now. He's going to break it down for us. The first قسم is, the first قسم الأول, قسم الأول is what? The first type is what?
منهم من قام بحقوق الإيمان كلها فهو المؤمن حقا.
This is the one who came with the rights of Iman, all of it. And this is a true believer. فهو المؤمن حقا. He is a true believer. He's a true believer.
ومنهم من تركها كلها فهذا كافر بالله تعالى.
This is the second قسم. The second type of people is the one who left the iman in totality. This is the opposite to the first one, and that is the kafir, the one who disbelieves in Allah تبارك وتعالى.
ومنهم من فيه إيمان وكفر أو إيمان ونفاق أو خير وشر. ففيه من ولايات الله
من ولاية الله
واستحقاقه لكرامته بحسب ما معه من الإيمان. وفيه من عداوات الله واستحقاقه لعقوبة الله بحسب ما ضيعه من الإيمان.
So the Sheikh رحمه الله, he now goes into the third group of people. And this is very powerful. That is it possible that a person can be a mu'min and a kafir at the same time? Na'am. Na'am. A person can be mu'minun and kafirun. Both of them could be present in him. That's what the Sheikh says, وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ فِيهِ إِيمَانٌ. Iman is present in him and kufr is present in him. Iman is present in him, nifaq is present in him. Khair is present in him, shar is present in him. فَفِيهِ, like in pay attention. What the Sheikh means that the iman is present in him is that the aslul iman he has. He can't have aslul iman and aslul kufri. It's impossible. And النَّقِضَانِ لَا يَجْتَمِعَانِ. Are you there? Did we not say right now that the iman is of shu'ab branches? Are you there, brothers? Are you all with me? Are we focusing here? What did we say? That the iman is what? Branches. Did we say that? Like the Prophet said that. Al-imanu bid'un wa situna shu'ba. A'laha qawlu la ilaha illallah wa adnaha imatatul adha anil tariq wal haya'u shu'batu min shu'ab al-iman. The Prophet is saying this. Shu'ba. It's a branch. So what do we learn? That the iman is of branches. Shu'ab. Branches. Is all of the branches foundation? Are they all sub-branches? Are they all furu'? Then there's sama asal, sama fara. Does kufr have branches? Naam. Just like iman has branches, kufr also has branches. Some of the branches of kufr is kufr akbar, and some of it is what? It's kufr asghar. Are you with me? Pay attention. So a person, are you there? If he comes with aslul iman, are you there? And he comes with something which Allah tabarak wa ta'ala prohibited him from. He has come with a shu'bah min shu'ab al-kufr. That's what the Prophet meant when he said, سباب المسلم فسوق وقتاله كفر. Killing a Muslim is a branch from the branches of كفر. It's شعبة من شعب الكفر. صح؟ So when a Muslim goes and kills another Muslim, we can say to him, إيمان وكفر. إيمان is in the sense where he's got أصل الإيمان is still there. But he has come with a branch from the branches of كفر, which is قتل, killing. صحيح؟ The Prophet said, لا ترجعوا بعدي كفارا يضرب بعضكم رقاب بعض. So this is a branch of branches. Does that make sense? Yeah. But it's not that أصل الإيمان and أصل الكفر are both present in him. The same is إيمان ونفاق. Does it mean that he's got أصل الإيمان and he also has أصل النفاق? No, it doesn't mean that. The nifaq that the Prophet is talking about here is what? The nifaq which is not aqadi. It's the nifaq which is amali. This is what the Shaykh is referring to. So the person can be what? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, what did he say? علامة المنافق ثلاثة إذا حدث كذب وإذا وعد أخلف وإذا تمن خان. صح؟ So any mu'min who comes with these characteristics, what do we say with it? What's with him? شعبة من شعب النفاق. He's got a branch from the branches of nifaq. So what is he at the same time? He's a mu'min. So he's got iman with him and he's got nifaq with him. Sahih? We also say he's got khair with him and he's also got shar with him. Does that make sense? That's what Sheikh means. Pay attention to this. فَفِيهِ مِنْ وِلَايَةِ اللَّهِ وَاسْتِحْقَاقِ لِكَرَامَتِي بِحَسَبِ مَا مَعَهُ مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ. Pay attention. Does he have أصل الإيمان, this person? Does he have what? أصل الإيمان. That أصل الإيمان makes me give him wilaya. He has rights on me as a wali. As a Muslim, I have to give him wala. Because he's a mu'min, he's not a disbeliever. فَفِيهِ مِنْ وِلَايَةِ اللَّهِ. You give him wala, brotherly love. وَاسْتِحْقَاقِهِ لِكَرَامَتِهِ. And also deserving to be honored. بِحَسَبِ مَا مَعَهُ مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ. Based on the iman which he has with him. وَفِيهِ مِنْ عَدَاوَةِ اللَّهِ. And also you have hate for him as well. واستحقاقي لعقوبة الله بحسب ما ضيعه من الإيمان because of the iman which he has forsaken. In other words, the شعبة of كفر which is in it with him, or the شعبة of نفاق that's with him. صح? That part I dislike him for it. صح? So now what do we learn, brothers? This false concept that people say, I hate the action but I don't hate the person who's doing it. أعوذ بالله. أعوذ بالله. You hate him. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did say, "أوثق عرى الإيمان الحب في الله والبغض في الله." I love and I hate for the sake of Allah. I love a person for the sake of Allah, and I hate somebody for the sake of Allah. You see. So, when you're loving a person, you're loving them لما معه من الإيمان, the iman which they have. Are you there? Now look at this. Somebody's iman is very weak and it's little. The love for them is going to be what? Little. A person has a mashallah, his iman is strong and he's powerful. His love and he's going to be more, right? Sahih? And the hate is going to be little. All of that is in correlation and it is in accordance to the person's iman that's with him and the kufr that might come to him or that which he may have. Now the question arises, which is, if that person, pay attention, he has nifaq and he has iman, and he has kufr and he has iman present at the same time. How do we address him? How do we refer to him? And how do we speak about him? Go to the Kitab Taysir al-Aziz al-Hamid, which is the sharah of Kitab al-Tawheed. Go to the Kitab Kitabul Iman by Muhammad by Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. Kitab Ta'zim al-Qadir al-Salah by Muhammad Nasir al-Marwazi. Kitab al-Iman by Ibn Manda. Kitab al-Iman written by Abu Ubaid Qasim ibn Salam. Are you with me, brothers? These books, they stated. Also, go to the sharh of Ibn Abil Izz al-Hanafi in Aqidat al-Tahawiyah. Are you with me, brothers? Are you there? Even that, though, what deserves to be pointed out is Ibn Abil Izz al-Hanafi, rahimahullah, fell in a mistake in this issue. When he was explaining Kitab Aqidat al-Tahawiyah, he mentions the khilaf between Ahlul Hadith and Ahlul Sunnah with the Ahnaf and the Hanafiyyah is a khilaf lafzi. It's a khilaf suri. That is not a real tangible khilaf. La, it is. It is. Are you with me, brothers? And how can it not be a khilaf which is haqiqi? Why can't it be a khilaf which is literal? when in reality they don't even believe إيمان يزيدوا وينقصوا. صح؟ Are you with me, brothers? They don't believe الإيمان يزيدوا بالطاعة وينقصوا بالمعصية. صحيح؟ Are you with me, brothers? And we spoke about three things that the إيمان, huh? Brothers, three things we spoke about. الإيمان قول وعمل يزيد بالطاعة وينقص بالمعصية. And we also said جواز الاستثناء في الإيمان لا باعتبار أصله, but not the أصل of it. صحيح؟ Anyone who negates any of those three that we mentioned, then he has come with a خلاف which is حقيقي. He's either taking the path of the خوارج or the path of the معتزلة or the path of the مرجع. صحيح؟ This خلاف becomes حقيقي. It's not a خلاف لفظي. لذلك ابن أبي العز الحنفي رحمه الله, in that statement of his, that the خلاف with the أحلاف is a خلاف لفظي, is not right. It's a خلاف حقيقي. You with me? ولذلك the فقهاء الحنفية are مرجع in إيمان. They are what? They are مرجع in the issue of الإيمان. نعم. That being said, there was a point I was mentioning now, which is that Sulaiman ibn Abdullah ibn Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, who is the grandson of Shaykh al-Islam Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, who I said was the first man who explained Kitab al-Tawheed. His Kitab is called Taysir al-Aziz al-Hamid. Are you with me, brothers? And was killed, by the way, unjustly. He was actually shot by the Egyptian leader al-Basha. He shot him. But he didn't finish the sharh of Kitab al-Tawheed. Sulaiman ibn Abdullah ibn Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. What his cousin did, like him. His cousin, whose name is Abdul Rahman ibn Hassan ibn Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, he actually finished the book. And what did he call it? He called it Fathul Majid, في شرح كتاب التوحيد. And his one is the one that people stand over and they study, and it could be said that it's the best one since it's complete. Whereas this one is not complete. Taysir al-Aziz al-Hamid is incomplete. If it was complete, it would have been the best. It would have been the best. And it's Fathul Majid, as I said, is a summary of Taysir al-Aziz al-Hamid, asalatan. And of course, he finished his book off. Anyways, the point that is, this person who has Iman and Kufr, or Iman and Nifaq, how should we address him? Should we call him a mu'min? Should we call him a kafir? How should we refer to him? He mentions that there are two ibaratani, two ways of addressing that person. The first way of addressing that person is you can say, he's a Muslim and he's not a mu'min. Sahih? Based on the concept which is what? Based on the concept which is, are you with me, brothers? The levels are three: Muslim, and then mu'min. If you go stronger, you become a mu'min, and then when you grow stronger, you become a muhsin. So it's either you're a Muslim at the beginning, and once you start becoming serious, you become a mu'min, and then you go ihsan, darajatul ihsan, right? So some group, they said, because he has imanun wa kufrun, he's a Muslim and he's not called a mu'min. He's not referred to as a mu'min. And that's a stage below iman, mu'min. Very good. The second group of scholars, what they said is mu'minun bi imanihi fasiqun bi kabirati. They said that he's a mu'min in the iman that's with him. Are you there? And he's a fasiq because of the kabira and the sins that he has, or the kufr which he has come with, or that he has with him. Are you with me, brothers? Are you there, brothers? This, of course, is referring to kamaluhu al-wajib. Are you there, brothers? This is all referring to kamaluhu al-wajib. Naam.
ويرتبون على هذا الأصل العظيم أن كبائر الذنوب وصغائرها التي لا تصل بصاحبها إلى الكفر تنقص إيمان العبد من غير أن تخرجه من دائرة الإسلام ولا يخلد في نار جهنم.
So the Sheikh رحمه الله, he mentions that Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah, if a person comes with a major sin, he comes with a major sin, and also the minor sins, that does not reach kufr. It does not what? It doesn't reach kufr. It doesn't reach kufr. This will say to him, it weakens and it reduces his iman, but it doesn't nullify his iman. It does not take him out of the da'irat al-Islami, from the fold of al-Islam. And it doesn't entail or does not make him go into the hellfire forever. No. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, in other words, he's speaking about a concept which is known as Murtakib al-Kabira. Sahih? There's Murtakib al-Kabira. The issue of Murtakib al-Kabira is a person who comes with major sins. What's his situation? And Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they said he is what? As I said before, Mu'minun bi imanihi fasiqun bi kabirati. Sahih? That's what Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah said. Are you with me? The Murji'ah, they said he's kamilul iman, his iman is complete. There's nothing wrong with him. They said, لا يضرُّ ذنبٌ, a sin does not harm مع الإيمان, with iman. He's come with iman, right? That won't harm him. Won't do anything to him. So that's what the path that the Murji'ah took. Then the Khawarij came, they stripped Islam from him. And they took him out of the fold of Islam. And they took him to Kufr, wal'iyadu billah. And they said he's going to stay in hellfire forever. Are you with me, brothers? Then the Mu'tazila came. And the Mu'tazila said something. They said he's not a mu'min and he's not a kafir. He's a manzilatun baylan manzilatayni. So they differ with the Khawarij in the hukm dunyawi, the worldly. In the dunya, they don't want to. The Khawarij will call it a kafir. They're a kafir. Sah. Kafir. The Mu'tazili will not call it a kafir. But they both come together in what? The Day of Judgment. Because the Mu'tazili, he believes the Day of Judgment, that person's in the hellfire forever. Sahih? No. Whereas the Khariji believes that the person's going to be in the hellfire forever. And then all they differ on is the concept of what should we give this person, what name should we give this person. Sahih? That's all they differ on, really. So the khilaf between the Mu'tazila and the Khawarij in this issue is a khilaf lafzi. I'm a khilaf suri. Because the khilaf doesn't have no thamara. It doesn't have a difference. Whether you call him a kafir or not, where is he in the hellfire? Where is he in the Day of Judgment? He's in the hellfire forever. Then that's all that matters. Na'am? Na'am? Araftum? Na'am. Whereas Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah, what do they say? Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah, they say, Muslimun, I'm a mu'minun bi imanihi, fasiqun bi kabiratihi. That's what Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah say. So the group which are the Murji'ah, they have become misguided from the straight path. Huh? And the Khawarij, they have also what? Become misguided from the straight path. And so did the Mu'tazila. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah always take the? Na'am, they took the middle path. So inshallah ta'ala, the Shaykh is going to go to many other points, inshallah ta'ala. We'll conclude there for today, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong, incorrect, shortcoming, is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.